I'm Amy Reed, Chief of Vascular Surgery here at Penn State Hershey Medical Center, and I am a vascular surgeon who did my medical school training at University of Wisconsin in Madison, and did my general surgery training at the Brigham and Women's Hospital in Boston, Massachusetts, and then also stayed on at the Brigham and did my vascular surgery fellowship there with a 3-month vascular fellowship in venous surgery at the Mayo Clinic. I got interested in vascular surgery during the second year of my residency when on the vascular surgery service, two of my mentors, Drs. Whittemore and Belkin, allowed me to help out with repair of a femoral pseudoartery aneurysm. And while doing that, I just recall really being fascinated with the procedure and the technique and the fine motor skills and instrumentation that was required, and thought, this would really be something I might be interested in pursuing. And even to this day now, going on nearly 12 years into my position, I'm still as fascinated as ever by the disease process. So I think the actual rotation on the service while I was a resident really got me interested. One of the things I really enjoy about vascular surgery is the wide variety of techniques and patients that you can deal with. One of the things that we find is that many times as a vascular surgeon, we deal with older patients who have a lot of different disease processes going on. And I find it very gratifying to be able to perform a life-saving procedure with an aneurysm repair or relieve pain or heal sores on a patient's leg by doing some of these procedures. And nowadays, many of these have become much less invasive. So whether I do this with an incision or a needle puncture where we're using a balloon or a stent, or sometimes medical therapy and just reassurance, it's very gratifying for some of these older individuals who have a myriad of problems and to not have to sometimes have them be admitted to the hospital and still be able to accomplish some of these things. And I think the patients really enjoy a much less invasive approach that we have today. Now, when I was first training, this was just coming into the forefront in vascular surgery, and we didn't know where the field would go with all of this. And I'm happy to say that all the techniques are at our disposal to treat the patients, and it's really made it a very exciting field to be in. One of the things I also like is the ability to treat multiple different areas. There's a lot of variety, whether we're working on the arteries in the neck or the arm or the chest or belly or legs, provides a lot of variety. It's also some extremes of ages. So we typically will work with elderly patients, but for some of the unusual arterial problems or venous problems, some of those are some younger patients, and so there's a broad range of ages. Occasionally we even get involved in some traumatic injuries, and occasionally sometimes in children, so it really provides a lot of variety. And I think because of the varying different techniques that we're able to utilize, it's made it just a very exciting field. What I enjoy most is, I think, the gratification of relieving some of the vascular problems that the patients have, and then following the patients long term. I think one of the things that drew me to the specialty was there's a fair amount of primary care in vascular surgery. Many of the patients we see, we may manage expectantly and not do an operation or procedure, may manage them medically, and we may also just follow them. Many times aneurysms are not in need of repair, a carotid stenosis is not in need of intervention, so it's reassuring for the patients to see us follow up, and many times they're delighted to just get news that things are stable, they're doing a good job with their primary care physician for medication. So I find the long-term relationships that we develop with the patients really quite a very fulfilling and rewarding part of the practice.